got a little bit of a back and forth going on right now. So there are mirrored plating armor that's growing on him, and there's also
that's cool.
What's happening?
I say that out loud.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
What's happening?
He's my first assimilation.
That's true. All
right. Oh, like it's happening to this creature thing, right?
It is happening.
That's pretty cool.
So do I. So what happens with what's happening to Julian right now?
He needs to roll to see if he can maintain any visions of himself.
So just like just a straight up roll. That's a roll better than 6, obviously.
Yeah.
No. 75.
Oh yeah, he just became.
He's me now.
Family reunion.
He is a 4-2.
He is
was a
4-2.
Syntech. I mean, basically, he was the alternate side of the Solaris system, but yeah, he's a 4-2.
Nicely done, 4-2.
At least that clone of him is.
Mm-hmm. And now,
so now I don't speak.
He has the same like directives that I have. Yeah.
He's you now.
Wait, not you.
No, you just took him. You just took that demon and made him.
Yeah.
4-2.
What just happened? What happened to my son?
Yeah, okay.
Long story.
Well, I've got the time for it.
Where do we begin?
Are the alarms still going?
He basically went from being your son to becoming like your great-grandchild.
I can show you what happened to him.
Just tell me.
Stein happened.
I can show you.
Stein always happens. He collected the poor souls that were your children. The battle-worn child. The crazy one. He just perfected them. Gave me the
crazy
body I
one.
Never had, and Julian all the power he could drink until he killed himself on it. Stein always does this. He ruins everything he touches. It's why he must die. It's why his technology must be taken and used for the greater good of humanity.
That's what I've decided to do with my gift that I gained on Earth as well.
I don't have time for gifts, Father. I have a world to save.
End scene.
I like that. That was really good. End scene. So you're in that chamber figuring out what happened to you.
Yeah, Harbinger and I went to the
Harbinger,
chamber.
Harbinger, he is responding to your feral nature by becoming more domicile and submissive.
Oh.
You're quite scary to him right now, so you need to go ahead and roll your diamond die again, or pyramid die again.
Okay.
Are you scared of him right now?
Still a 1.
Wow. Fang is staying in control.
Sorry, just like, nah, I haven't played at all.
I don't know how he's going to hack stuff, but...
Adrian!
What does he want to do in this room?
He remembers how he was split apart.
He remembers his essence being used to create different things, yes.
And he sees the chambers that it was put into?
Yeah. Each of them still there, but they are empty. There are obviously clipboards and computers and all sorts of stuff.
I feel like he would destroy the tubes that his essence was put into.
Alright.
Because he needs to stop that from happening ever again.
Go for it.
That is a 37. What would that be, physical?
Yeah, I mean, he's a spiritual part of you, but fear physical attack, I would assume.
Okay, so I'm probably using my tasers. Because that would be the way that my body would attack. Most likely. Unless I'm using a blade that I found. I haven't found a blade here, so I'm going to be using the taser, because that's the way I would attack. 37 out of 52.
Okay, so as you begin to attack one of the pods, lashing out with your electrical attack, Harbinger responds in kind to your directive and begins to attack the other one, lashing out at it with its long and powerful tail.
Excellent.
As you damage and destroy these two tubes. One of them labeled with numeral 1, one of them labeled with numeral 2.
Excellent. Now they will never be able to do that again.
All right, now, of course, you storming off can hear these explosions happening down the hallway.
And you probably heard my guttural
more
cry
fun.
Of joy.
You hear somebody howling.
I go from just like a brisk power walk to like Terminator. What was it? The T-1000?
Hover move.
Just high hands down the hall as fast as I can.
So as you get to this room, you notice that Mune's got full force chaos and is destroying these tubes, and his monster is doing the same with him.
What in the unknown realms do you think you're doing?
This is where they split me. I had to stop it.
Split
it can't happen
who?
Again. Me.
Who is me? Unless your name is Moon, I do not care.
How do you not know Fengar? I am the aspect of life.
Hold up my hand.
I have no time for your whimsical mysticism, beast.
Alistair, who is this man?
I am Fengar.
The human before you, his name is Moon. The numerous things occupying his brain, I can't tell you.
So you're saying he has split personality?
I will not be disrespected. It's a 90 to attack you.
You will be disrespected.
You will be disrespected. We can see. Maybe he busts worse.
48 out of 80.
You're going to be disrespected.
Know your place, beast.
How do you show him his place?
As he's swiping at me,
yeah.
I grab by the wrist and twist back, almost like break it, just like force him down.
You see? They have weakened me.
He is definitely my son.
I'll let go and just, I'm done here.
Detective, you're in this room, you see this happening, you see these devices that he destroyed, the files, the computers, what do you do?
I gotta try, are the computers destroyed too?
No,
or
just the tubes.
Just the tubes.
I wanna see what I can find.
Okay.
Yay, this just is actually here. In realm of it, 42 out of 60.
How many?
42! Alright, so as you hack into the system, several different files upload Project Wild Hunt. And you start going through files, Project 1, the Fang. You start reading through those files, and then you see Project 2, Shadow of the Fang, codenamed Falco. And you start reading through that file of how they cloned this hunter's DNA.
Huh. Just out of curiosity. So, Fengar.
Yes. They split me.
There's one called Shadow of the Fang. His codename was Falco. That's what they use this for. Do I find anything about any of the McTavish brothers?
Not in this laboratory.
I couldn't find anything about the McTavish brothers in here. I don't know what kind of monstrosities they did to you, but Stein will pay.
Stein's already dead.
What?
Yeah.
Which one?
Take a number. There could be another one out there right now. A little baby Stein. Little demon bundle of joy.
That's not how that works.
Clone Steins. Like, they're the same. It's like code.
Out of curiosity, would Solaris know that the shards are connected to the guardian beast? Because technically
he was part of
them. He is
he was formed from one.
Yeah.
Maybe he had that idea.
Okay. I'm trying to kind of get on a level of like
bonded with them when he destroyed the big threat at the end of the
this isn't my first time meeting Fengar then.
No.
This isn't your first rodeo.
We literally fought together.
You used him to make the big glass.
Don't puff your chest out at me, then Fangar. I am, it's big. I go over to Fangar. Are you okay?
I will be once I'm made whole.
I don't know
how what certain if
that is.
We extract the DNA of Fangar's and use it to make a clone.
That's literally what he just destroyed for two.
You just destroyed your ability to separate from this body. The cure.
I need to be made whole, not separated.
That would have made you whole. You're not in.
We have the technology to.
You're in Wayfinder.
Can construct a blank slate that we can download.
You're inhabiting a shell.
Okay. This is my body.
It is not your body. It's Wayfinder Mune's body.
This is where I was tortured. I was split.
Yes, your mind is present in another vessel. That also houses.
I'm doing that now.
Some other personalities as well. Falco being one of them.
What are you doing?
So you and Shadowfang are in the
same. I saw him telepathically what I'm doing.
Okay, so he's just going to let you know that he's trying to make a blank slate, but obviously, since the two chambers in this room are broken, it is relaying to a different room.
Tell him to go. Can I ping that location? Or no.
Yeah, sure.
I'm telling him to go monitor to make sure nothing weird happens.
I will go. And 4-2 will remain here.
I am inclined to trust you.
Are you sending?
There are two 4-2s.
Yeah. Roger, roger.
From where I'm from, I'm a detective. I try to help those in need.
A detective? That sounds like a hunter.
I'm a hunter of criminals.
I am a hunter.
The greedy underbelly.
We could hunt together.
As you enter the other room,
indeed,
you do see the chamber, and it's starting to weave together a body.
Okay. I'll monitor it and relay the information. Also, I have a question for the DM.
Out of character?
Yes.
Okay, go for it.
What the heck's
the, you know, my ability to access, like, you know, processing power and stuff like that, due to like the likelihood of my success.
Mm-hmm.
So the question is, since I have like duplicated myself successfully, does that increase the likelihood by that amount?
You should probably write that down as a skill, processing power or something.
Okay.
And then just put like a 2% next to it. So each time you duplicate yourself, that percentile goes up.
Okay. How much does it go up by? One or two or? Two.
Depends on how many times you multiply yourself, I guess.
Is it exponential growth?
It could be. Like, okay. I mean, if you found a crowd of people and you exponentially grew, then yeah.
Well, like, so, like, if I, like...
Don't get into math on me. I will go cosmic centimeters on you.
Well, it's really simple. If I...
out the whiteboard. I thought it was simple, too.
If I, it's like, not. Assimilate two people, and then each one of them... goes and assimilates to.
That's right. Oh, I understand pyramid schemes.
Yeah. Yeah. That's exponential growth.
Now, as y'all are all busy, an alarm 2% continues to blare in the hallway. It seems to be shrouding any other noise that you may be able to hear, so you would need to roll to see if you perceive anything. Everyone do so.
Yes, 40 out of 60.
18 out of 20.
Am I in the same 11 room? 11
out of 40, so I'm going to use survival.
Okay, so you definitely all notice that there seems to be somebody maneuvering in the hallway.
Makes
it's
sense.
Not the 242s.
I'm the hunter, so it makes sense.
Am I near the hallway? Do I need to roll?
You're in that other room.
Okay. But what about the other 42? The other 42 could now.
Unholster the judge.
Yeah, there's the other 42.
And get it ready.
31. Does he know?
I think he knows, yeah. Everybody seems to know that there's something maneuvering in the hallway.
I ready the judge. The judge is ready.
I prepare Harbinger.
The beast is ready.
I'm still working on the computer. Getting ready
to... continues to hack.
I figured I'd be hacked in by now.
Oh. Well, what were you hacking it for? You already...
Oh, wasn't it? Yeah, I was waiting to make sure that I got that successful before I went on to the next
step. Yeah, he went into the other room. He relayed to you the information that it is weaving the body.
Well,
it's pretty cool.
How badly do you want that body?
I have a body.
Where is it?
I admit it.
Enough of this. Boom! And then I try to download Vangar's personality, his spirit or whatever, from that, and I try to put it into the empty
shell. That would be shell. Slippery mind.
Can I put some nanobots in the empty shell since I'm in the room?
It's a 59 against 80. So 59 out of 80. And I have advantage, so that drops it by 10, right?
55 out of 50.
Turns out he's, again, not a computer. That's a spiritual thing, so...
let me help you.
If only you had a dagger to stab into his head and absorb that essence.
Red-headed boy.
Get ready to roll defense.
Roll defense.
You're the one at the door with the gun, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. 17. Okay, pretty good. So you see as this dark shape enters the room carrying a large sword with a red gem in its center, the rest of this body seems to be covered in a black living armor that has sharp spikes all over it. As it lashes out, you blast forward with the judge. Roll your damage die.
My damage die?
Yeah.
Ooh.
He doesn't seem to have the aura coming off of him this time, so that's good.
How close is he?
He is in your face.
He's in my face? Okay, so that's going to be a step up of 4 times. Plus, let's see, 15. Plus that. Sorry, a lot of math. This is about 85. So, 3d10.
All ones.
Good luck, Dad.
Don't put that on him.
Good luck, Dad.
You're a hero.
It's at least one.
20.
Pretty good. So as you do this, you take a shot at him. Mm-hmm. It hits the arm not holding the sword, mm-hmm. but it blasts him back and severs that arm from his body. As it falls to the ground and turns into a pool of black liquid that then starts to scurry off down the hallway.
Take an action surge to shoot that pool.
Okay.
Right, riddle ballistics. 36 out of 85.
Okay.
And then 3d10. I'll just roll my percent, so I'll pretend it's a 10. It's a 14. 17. So shoot the full.
Okay. So as you do that, it splatters even further into a smaller pool, but mm-hmm. then from the damage, seeming to grow fearful, it runs like it oozes almost alive and scurries underneath a door to its right. 4-2, roll perception.
72, is that mental?
Yeah.
6. It's just 70.
So you do not notice as this black ooze yeah. maneuvers past you into the chamber containing the newly formed body.
I haven't managed to infiltrate yet.
You also added nanobots into the water, so that's interesting.
We'll see what happens with that.
Did Harbinger also get to attack? He was readying.
Harbinger's ready to attack?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see what he can do.
So that is a 66.
Of course, Harbinger of Death gets a 66.
I don't know his actual stat on that for the attack. Here. So he's good.
He has to roll 3d10s.
Yep.
Neat. So that is also a 21. No, 20.
Good. Good. Yeah, so he lashes out with his tail and also pierces through this thing. As he does, it seems to drop down into an ooze. Again, losing form and scurrying.
Does the sword remain solid?
No. No. Okay. The jewel does seem to move with the black ooze, though.
Hmm.
Do I notice this? Not the jewel is moving with the ooze?
As a detective, I would think so.
Get that jewel.
You, sir.
I'm going to turn.
Son, get the jewel.
I'm going to...
Get the jewel, son.
With my...
Get Julian. No, jewel.
I'm going to do overcharge with empower.
Step back.
I step back.
It's mental plus...
That's too much of a man to say, okay.
I tell Harbinger
yeah,
to
just like,
disappear
I'm
down the hall.
I'm smart. I'm like, I'm not forward.
Yeah.
I step back.
I call Harbinger game. Back.
Ooh, that's close. 79 out of 80.
How much do you have to do?
60.
How much do you have?
70. I'm dropping down to 10. I'm aiming directly at the shard.
As you see this, a blinding flash of light consumes the hallway. Even you, 4-2 in your room, can see the light glaring from beneath the crack of the door, and you can hear what's going on within your chatter.
And mentally, like, I...
And because you're there, too. It's very confusing with you now. You're a triangle. But you see this blinding flash of light consume the hallway into a bright white until it gradually fades, and the blind spots begin to clear from your eyes, and you see all that remains... is a sizzling cinder on the ground and that small red jewel.
I'm gonna go try to pick it up.
Okay. It's not hard, it didn't run away from you. It's now just a jewel. Okay, so it picked it up. Got it.
They call me Betty.
Roll your triangle.
Oh, God. Let's
see what they call me. That's a one.
Now, in the alternate room, the pod begins to crack and break open as the body of a man is released forth, spilling onto the ground with the waters.
I'm like, darn it! It's not supposed to happen like that. What went wrong?
As he looks up at you with almost a blank stare, he doesn't really realize where he is.
Activate nanobots.
They seem to be responding in a very odd fashion. They don't relay back to you quite right.
Uh-oh.
Introduce new nanobots to figure out what's wrong with the old
run systems agnostic.
42 out of 80.
Very fitting.
The new nanobots, when approaching its body, seem to be reacted to by a black ooze that reaches out and attacks each one of them.
Search database for black ooze. And now, of course, I am aware of like what they just fought, and so I'm including that information in my query.
Yes.
40 out of 80, and I have a 2% on my CPU.
Okay, so you search the database, and the only thing that comes up is from the time of Darkstar. You do know that there was an infection that was going around.
And anything about like what that infection does?
They called it the Darkstar strain. Seemed to be where you got a lot of your ideas from on making a communal mind.
Competitive communal mind. All right, I will. Are there any nanobots left in the body?
They're in there, but they seem to be operating a different function. Relaying different information.
Oh my God. You just
Okay, I try to
get Fangar a new body.
We make Frankenstein.
Try to get Fangar a new body.
The specimen, like, you know, there's probably a built-in system for that here.
I call this Solaris'
okay.
Monster.
So, as you're waking up on the ground,
destroy the experiment.
You see this shiny robot in front of you.
Hey.
Can I help you?
What's your roll?
Yeah, I mean, like,
what is your roll?
It doesn't work. The incinerate button, I'm like here, like, while he's talking to me.
Just trying to get
it doesn't work.
Do you understand words, boy? Are you a toaster? Can you speak?
Where do you come from?
From here. I don't know, it's kind of foggy.
What is your name?
Do I have a name?
I think it'd be like coming to you. Or you might give yourself one. There seems to be a consciousness within you, but you don't know where it came from.
From what I can recall, friends call me Mr. Well.
Mr. Well?
Yes.
Can I do a search for a Mr. Well? Like a throughout time and space.
You might be able to narrow that search.
There is a catalog of one known as Inkwell.
What is Inkwell? That's all
it's a mystery. A mystery within a mystery. But there does seem to be a top secret file on it.
Is it encrypted?
It is encrypted.
He's saying this out loud.
No. Okay, this is all happening in a nanosecond.
The nanosecond of the nanomind.
All you see is...
Yeah, I do. I have
who knows what was going on in the computer system?
I swear, take a nap.
You seem to have a built-in personality. As far as I am aware, you have just been created.
Created?
Yes.
I was born. Man and a woman. They loved each other very well.
I point to the broken tube. It's like, well, this is your mother and I am your father.
Never mind that nonsense. Where am I? And who are you?
Can I walk into the room?
You would hear them talking.
What is going on here? Well, looky here. Another new face. Come to take a gander at me in my birthday suit.
Who are you?
I've just told your toaster here. My name's Mr. Well.
Who is he?
He's Mr. Well.
How did he get here?
I just created him. Something was interfering.
Oh, so he's a clone.
He is in part a clone.
Clone?
Yes, a clone. You're a copy of the original.
No.
Mr. Well.
I am the original. Mr. Well. There's only one Mr. Well.
He shouldn't have the memory of anyone. But he doesn't have memory. He has feelings. It's very curious.
Listen here, Samsung.
Do you remember?
I won't be taking lit from an appliance. You seem like a red-blooded, good, upstanding Alorian guy.
No. I'm not from Alorian. I'm from Jesus. Earth.
Foreigners. What is going on here? Where am I? And why am I naked?
You're in a Stein lab. You're a
who is Stein?
He's a math scientist.
He's the guy that made you naked. Figures.
Can I like scan his brain for
basically
like...
Basically, you're just rebirthed.
Rebirthed?
Yes.
Born we're born again.
That's one of them.
Is that one of...
Second chance at seeing, boy.
Is reborn. Is that someone of these newfangled, new age religions I've been hearing about?
No, not one of those.
Can't pick up a newspaper these days without reading about them.
You've got a second chance at life. This is what's
second
happening.
Second chance at life. I wasn't done living my first chance.
So do you remember
apparently
your first
you
chance?
There I was.
He remembers.
As y'all continue to talk in this room, Fangar, you, Harbinger, and Solaris, and the second 4-2 mm-hmm. are in the other original room. What do you do?
And Solaris just picked up the red gem.
He just picked up a red gem.
And burned all of the ink that we saw.
Correct.
I am going to try and incorporate this red shard into my red shard.
You can incorporate the red gem into your body. Roll for it. To incorporate this.
Time to adapt.
I know what you're doing, but...
No, 68.
Okay, so you recognize that this is not a source shard. that it is a pre-programmed crystal that has technological abilities, but you cannot download the information into yourself.
We'll study this for later, I guess. Put it away.
I'm a little thigh. Just,
little RoboCop belt.
Solaris.
Is Robo Fanny
Pack? Yeah, what's up? If that thing does what it just did in your belt pocket,
it'll be contained.
Okay, you got better belt pockets than I do. Can you make me some belt pockets? I know you were trying to make me a body.
Stein told me a story about this crazy fellow.
I don't like Stein.
He based my pockets on a cape.
Second 4-2, you're in the room with them. You see this happening?
He just put the red gem into a pocket. And he said that it's going to be completely safe because his pockets were based off of Steintech that was based off of a guy that used pockets in the past.
That was just a joke.
Do I know what that red gem does?
You can try to run a scan on it through his hip.
You looking at my hips?
4-2.
See something you like?
Oh, he got it. He got a 4.
Woo! Okay, so as you scan it, you can actually log into his brain to scan what's in his body.
Right.
And you realize that this gem was actually a pre-programmed tool that was empowered with this goop stuff. And basically, while the gem was functioning, it would translate information to the goop to give it form so that it could attack things. You recognize that the gem itself was manufactured in a different plant facility, one called the Infernal Forge.
Infernal Forge. Will that gem actually control the goop, or?
The gem was controlling the goop.
Do you say that out loud?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Fangar wouldn't really care, but Falco might.
Well, who's in control?
Who's got their hands on the steering wheel?
Well, there's still goop.
The bus.
No, he fried the goop.
Kind of doing
well. Well, there's still goop inside of the clone.
Thing. You know about that.
Yeah.
So far, we don't.
Actually, he didn't see the goop get into it, but he did.
He
see
detected
it
the goop.
His nanobites.
Yeah.
So.
And I'm aware. Yeah, I'm aware of the goop itself. And then, like, I was like, this must have something to do with it. Can I borrow your gem for a moment?
Just jakes out a coin.
I'm like, kink. And I walk it into the other room with the other 4-2. I hand him. And no words need spoken. And I, 4-2 takes it.
Now hold on a second. There's two of you now.
Yeah, there's two of them. He
great. Got a dishwasher and
took over a clone of my son.
I'm sorry, what?
He assimilated the clone of my son.
Buddy.
Buddy, can I use the gem to like control the black goop, controlling my nanobots.
Stein happened to my life.
I stroke my fancy mustache.
Alright. I will attempt to get him to stop stroking his mustache.
Okay, so you've
been trapped on Aloria for a long time. Trying to find a way back.
What are you trying to do?
As 21.
So you feel a strange pull to stop stroking your fancy mustache.
Hey now. What's going on here? I don't really like this.
He seems to react to your mental control, but not towards infection.
Not towards infection? What do you mean?
So your nanobots don't seem to be able to infect it, but while you're holding this red stone, it seems like you have some sort of control function with it.
Do I notice him? Does Mr. Well notice him at the gym?
You notice that you feel funky.
You feel funky right after 1-4-2 handed the other 4-2 something.
Hey there. What are you two little chrome dudes doing? I don't like it. It's very shifty.
This is who you are.
Who's that exactly? I'm Mr. Well. I know who I am. Who are you?
Follow the first 4-2.
Is Mr. Well, can I communicate to the black goop while I'm holding the gem?
It doesn't seem to have any consciousness besides Mr. Well. It is Mr. Well.
So Mr. Well is not the clone. It is the goop.
Seemingly so.
That's curious.
Curious or incurious?
Hmm. Can I pull the goop out of the clone with the stone?
You can try.
Hmm. Can I quickly clone a cat?
Keep what?
I'll clone a cat and put the goop inside the cat.
You would have to program the cloning machine to build a cat.
Yeah. We're not going
and we're not at the Prime facility, so y'all already figured out that you can't force a new
all
body.
Of my nudeness. I'm going to focus a little tickling sensation in my head. I'm going to try to use.
I've noticed the strange patterns of 4-2.
So you roll.
4-2.
You have to roll against them.
What have you found, 4-2? It seems like you found something. What information is
17 out of 50.
42.
Okay, so the naked man attacks the robot with the shard.
Yes, but it's more so how I'm doing it. Well, not really attacking him.
Let me know what you're
doing. Almost kind of like on second instinct, mm-hmm. my shadow kind of just like shimmers and attaches itself to his. And through the void rune, I'm going to try to bind him there.
So basically, you've frozen him with his shadow. Mm-hmm. And what do you do with that?
I'm going to try to extend his hand out to me and I'll see if I can make him mimic my movement. Like a marionette.
So in his control ratio over you, he won with that role exchange, and he's basically having you offer him the dread stone.
Oh. The other 4-2 robot comes in.
Okay, so the other 4-2 robot, what does the other 4-2 robot do?
He takes the stone. And
well, he's
going
to have to, so there's like, y'all are right here with each other, and he's going to make the move, so he would need to do something pretty immediate to try and stop him from getting the stone.
All right. He, like, attacks this guy. The naked man.
Okay, so y'all see the chrome domes attacking the naked man.
Well, wouldn't it just be one of them? Since the other one's stuck in place.
The other one's stuck, yeah. And one of them's attacking you.
Yeah. I'm Fangar.
So Larry's just going to post up outside the door and watch. Just like,
I don't trust either of them. I'm just going to kind of just step back and watch and see what happens and study to see what abilities these two have.
Okay.
I'm going to try and use my enchantment ability to, once he gets the stone, get him to give it to me.
Hot potato.
Okay. So you're going to need to roll against him on that. But, so he's grabbing the stone, you're going to need to roll for second 4-2 to attack Mr. Well.
Do I need to roll a defense against that?
Yeah.
Four.
Wow. It's 40 plus 18. 58. Mm-hmm. Oh wait, sorry. That was 2d10. So, let me just roll these. 95.
You get a favor. You win the exchange. You have tackled the naked man with your second 4-2.
Get off your cold hands. It's making me feel uncomfortable.
Your flesh is uncomfortable, so I will complain.
Your existence is uncomfortable. That's right, I said it. You
no,
robots
so
freak me out.
There's, your curiosity
I would like to compel
is not sufficient
holding
to keep you alive.
The gem to give it to me instead for safekeeping.
You might not die if I rip
out
your heart, but you will feel it.
All right, you need to roll a defense.
You're attacking me?
No. Being compelled.
To do what?
Give the gem to him.
I looked at you, the one that's holding the gem, and said, you should give that to me for safekeeping.
You realize there is more than one will that you have to fight.
But one of them is sitting on him.
75.
Oh, no. Yeah, he had 17, man. I don't think you're beating that.
All right, can I have 4-2, like, run up and grab it from 4-2 before he gives it to him?
Well, no, at this point, he's compelling you, so you're pretty much wanting to give it to him.
All right.
So, you have the red stone.
I have the red stone.
What does Fangar do with this red stone?
It obviously was used to control someone. Yeah. It seemed to also be controlling him. I don't like things that control things. I'm going to try and break it.
Okay.
Taser face.
Oh, that was the quickest character.
3 out of 60?
That's a really good one.
You crushed the red stone. Yeah.
Wow.
That is a dead red stone.
What happens to Mr. Well?
As you do this, you look over at Mr. Well, and he seems to just have a smile on his face as a black suit forms upon his body. Very nice suit. Three-piece. He, like, has a vest. Everything.
All black, minus just a white tie, white gloves.
You feel very free. Almost as if something wasn't grabbing at you anymore.
Dude, did I get any of my memories come back?
A little bit.
So that's what it was. You can call me Ignatius Nathaniel Crane of House Crane.
Can I run like a name check on that now that
friends
I have more information?
Call me Mr. Well, though.
You can't.
You decide.
Was it successful?
It looks like that gem was keeping him from being able to be his full self.
49. That's good. And I guess I have a...
Yes.
I don't know how we're going to factor in, like, the extra 2%.
Oh, God.
I would say...
So it would probably just be, like,
you are?
Add the two.
Yes, I am.
It's basically like an extra skill that you can apply.
So that would be a 43 then.
Or, is this
or like, add it on...
Add it on to the whole term, to be
honest.
Okay. So whatever you're doing is increasing that processing speed.
I'm all about two things.
3%,
power,
you'll add
money.
3.
Okay.
So you'll just say that's more.
That makes sense. It's easy to do it that way.
Right.
Too.
And then plenty of people like to get a good cost. Put many of them in jail.
That's 82. And I got 45.
Okay.
Very much
so,
like
Ignatius,
mm-hmm.
You have to present him with some lore on your character. He's doing a background check on it.
Very well.
All future employees require background.
Sir, you're about to have your mind blown. House Crane. Ignatius is from a family that is a divergent from House McTavish. So, these two families at one point were connected. They are now two halves of the same coin.
So, like, in essence, like, you're part of a family that's, I'm a part of your family.
Distant. At some point.
So basically, one side of the family went into law and order, and
yeah.
The other one went into organized crime.
And one
which
became goo, and one became machine.
Wait, would I recognize his last name?
No, organized crime is still
well,
law
he hasn't,
and order.
Oh, yes, I guess he did give
I
it.
I mean,
as a McTavish?
As a McTavish. I mean, that's why I kind of, I was like, uh-oh, you got introduced first. Yeah, he would recognize it. I mean...
Probably
maybe
like
not immediately.
Crane.
What was your last name? I didn't catch it.
James McTavish.
Ah, yes. The McTavishes. Bunch of dirt on their nose, goody two shoes. Kiss a lot of butts to climb ladders, don't you?
That wouldn't be me. I'm not from here.
You would also remember with your freedom from that control stone that you were being experimented upon. A different facility known as the Infernal Forge.
Do you know anything about Stein?
Does the Infernal Forge ring the bell to any of you?
I'm aware of that facility.
Who are you right now?
I was Fangar.
Roll.
I am Wayfinder Mew.
Alright. You don't have any knowledge of it?
No.
Infernal Forge. I'm not familiar with that. I'm still just trying to figure out what happened to Julian and Alistair. Apparently, Alistair McTavish is now Solaris.
That is right, Father.
And Julian.
Julian is the scumbag.
So, I guess not all McTavishes are from the same cloth. I guess we're the deviant McTavishes, I guess. Because I am from
the black
land.
Sheep. He drank too much from the cup Stein presented him.
And I am a descendant.
Well, I guess that boy had more grain in him than he cared to admit. Sure he was really your son there?
I wink, but no one saw.
Yes, I'm sure he was my son.
How sure?
4-2 after
well,
heard
see when a man and a woman do
oh,
things.
I know all about
yes,
the miracles. McTavish.
Exactly.
So,
from
how
the
faithful
history,
was your
you would be able to know that it is
that is the question I
for all I know, faithful. I have an operative there right now. And some
you may not, who knows? It is on the eastern continent.
I had a
and it seems
test.
To be an old lighthouse that's been converted into a Star Trek facility.
A lighthouse?
Oh, God.
Oh, God, is the roof burned?
It's all in the basement.
So the infernal floor. Oh, that's right. I was you that day. I forgot. He's looking at me like, I don't know about any lighthouse.
I'll continue. I'll relay the information that is pertinent to the other Syntech in the room besides myself.
Okay.
Is that me?
Yeah.
Lighthouse, you say? Seems worth checking out, I guess.
We're going to a lighthouse?
Yes, a lighthouse, Father.
Is this where the Eternal Forge is?
I cannot say, but I mean, a lead is a lead, is it not?
Well, I think all of us should go over there, Mr. Well. Do you want to accompany us? To find this madman that experimented upon you and had you under his control?
Well,
I'm sure you didn't like that. Maybe give him a taste of his own medicine.
Doing right with the law, but
this ain't doing right with the law. This is getting revenge.
We cranes. We're no one's puppet.
I like this guy. Oh, wait, I'm not that guy.
Yeah, you're different guy.
Are you? So
I'm immune now.
What is your name?
I am Wayfinder Mune.
Oh,
what is your name?
I'm glad you're back, friend.
I am James McTavish.
Yes, it's good to meet
detective.
You.
Detective. This is my estranged father. He didn't have time for me and my brother growing up, so guess, you know, no time like the present.
He and I
right,
were
Dad.
Twin experiments in this
twin
very
experiments.
Facility.
Yes, I am the body, he was to be the mind. Together we were the perfect weapon.
So that's what happened when you were kidnapped.
Kidnapped?
Yes.
No, I was a soldier in the Alorian army. A bomb went off and destroyed my body, and Stein strapped what was left into this. Well, wasn't this advanced. Thanks to Solaris, though.
When you were babies, you were stolen from me.
Guess Stein's full of surprises.
We found your dad?
Unfortunately, yes.
It wasn't Stein.
No.
I was worried that Stein was my dad.
Would I know the virtual reality programs?
Yeah, you had already
oh,
investigated this facility quietly before
yeah.
they got here.
He used them on all of us. Oh, God.
I look at Alistair. I think Stein used a virtual reality machine on you. I found information on it.
I rolled a 4. What does that mean for my mental state?
It means you're going... Daddy?
Mm.
It's me, Al.
I'm your big boy now, Papa. You literally just got done telling Griff.
I'm going to deep dive into my own mind. Maybe.
You already
Griff
know how to look for
alive.
Those signs.
It's not too impossible. Stein had me convinced that I was blown up as a soldier in the Lorian army, so.
What did he have Julian convinced of?
Honestly, I don't know.
Apparently that he was insane.
Julian was insane. Sick in the head.
As you're saying this to each other, there is a blank mirrored
Forter
staring at you as you're reflecting in his mirrored face talking to of it, as he was once the clone body of Julian McTavish.
That still does not sit right with me. It makes my skin crawl.
I am the culmination of your two
families. I don't care if you're the culmination of what's her name I met last Tuesday and the blonde before that. Don't matter to me, Mr. IKEA. The point is, you creep me out.
I remember IKEA. That was a good show.
Yes, unfortunately. A lot of spare parts.
What? It's IKEA.
Spare parts, man. You can
take
that.
Are we getting the show on the road, or are we just going to sit here and, you know, be emotional?
We could probably teleport there. There was a pad.
There's a pad?
Now you're telling me about this?
Yes, is there any more, DNA cloning material?
It goes to Prime.
Solaris has a whole bunch of DNA material logged right
into
it.
Necessarily have to.
Core processing.
I walk off back into that room, and I start programming up a body.
Maybe.
To go to the infernal forge?
Maybe.
The
it would make sense if he could teleport between the facilities.
To go to for mass production is what they're talking about.
Are we communicating together?
Forge.
Still, though, it'd be nice to go there with a little bit more than just two me's. Three me's is better.
Wait,
Stein and
I forget which me was in the room when I teleported. That was Falco that teleported. Blutterage. I am Mewn right now. Would
Falco and Mewn
the two of them share memories.
Yeah,
so.
You're both
that being the right location?
Shadow Out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Are you telling me that that's the location we need to go to?
Oh, the Forge?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. That is the location we need to go to.
So, I remember...
I was just trying to tap
how
a little
to
extra
teleporter
clone body here.
Was Prime the only place that it could go?
You don't think it's needed?
No. So, I'm going to go back to the pad.
Body here while we left.
So I'm going to go back to the pad.
No, I don't want him with me. I would like to leave a spare here.
And I'm going to ask Harbinger to come with.
So one of his spares is going to stay here to try to build more bodies. The other one's going to go with y'all. And y'all are going to teleport to the forge.
He wants to. I think he wants to create a third body to leave that third one here while him and 4-2 and 4-2A come with us to the forge.
Roll it. Just roll it. If it's a success, you can make a third body.
It's a fail.
That's a 95. That's a crit fail.
You get a favor.
Yeah.
That you
the
can
machine
use later.
Is wasted.
It is broken.
You need to go to the next place to find a new machine.
If only somebody hadn't destroyed that other tube.
Mm. What's the shiny one doing?
I think he's deciding whether he's going
to
go with us.
Trying to make another body.
All right, so I'm going to go ahead and fast forward the scene for you.
Yeah.
Since that machine's wasted, Wayfinder Mune, Solaris, Mr. Crane, Mr. McTavish, or Detective McTavish, sorry, and 421, 422 are all on the telepod, and... are porting out to the forge.
And Harbinger.
I do have to rename myself.
I have set it on
a 421.
I've set it on a delay for the teleport.
And then you hop on.
Yeah.
And you take a picture. And as you do, you vanish from this facility to go to a different one. What will happen to them? We don't know. Will they make it successfully? Will parts of their bodies be swapped with each other? Tune in next time to find out. This was Tony Stevens and the crew of the H.R.R.T Squad as it is being built and rebuilt over and over again. We'll see what new things we have in store for you next time. Join us next time at the same Saturday Night Gaming channel on the same Saturday Night Gaming night. That's Saturday. So, love you guys. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
So we can have more subscribers.